This is the video for the operation of the SPS 530 for the grill in Aylesbury, Buckinghamshire. The first operation you must do when you're using the machine is to sign in onto the flat keyboard. On here you can see in grey you've got employee 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Basically just select the one that you want, for example employee number 1. If you've already signed on and you press the button, it will sign you back off again. For the example right now, I'm going to press employee number 2. It comes up, number 2 employee. The next thing to do is to select the tables, which is this button here in red. What that does is it brings up on the screen a list of 10 tables. At the bottom it says sequence floor and number 1 ground. If we're already on ground, there's no need to press the button. But if we're going to a different floor, we press the button here, ground, and it brings up a new list with number 1 ground, first floor, top floor. So for this example, I'll press number 2 now for first floor. It brings up a list of 10 tables, and I can press whichever table I want. If I want to put in the number of guests on the table, I press the guest button here, type in, for example, 5, OK, then I press the table that I want, for example, number 12. OK, and then what I want to do now is, if I press this button here, as you can see, it's changed colour to green from pink. If I press it again, that means I'm choosing this table now to actually choose the foods that I want on the flat keyboard. Now, if it's just a straightforward entry, for example, olives or pepper and pita, I just press the button. Right now I'll press sheet kebab, and on the screen it comes up with the product, sheet kebabs, brackets 2. That's dead straightforward. If it's a grill item, if I press, for example, 6 ounce fillet, on the screen we get a menu asking us what to choose for the cooking style. For example, medium, so click medium. That comes up on the screen there. And then I press the button called done. And then that brings us back to the list of items here. Now, if that's the only thing that the customer is having, if I press the store order button, that'll then bring up a receipt with the order number 171, table number 12, and then the items, sheet kebabs 2, 6 ounce fillet steak, that's medium, and then it has an item count 2, so the actual kitchen staff can see what that is. Now you can give that receipt to the kitchen staff, and that's actually been stored on the system. If for example we're selling some items like steak sides, if we actually just press the button here, you can see that on the screen it brings up a list of items: mushrooms, tomatoes, mash, chunky chips. Again, that's just like using the steak items. You choose the item you want, that comes up on the screen, and then done. If I press cash now, that gives the receipt out to give to the kitchen, and if I press the blue receipt button, that has a receipt for the customer to pay, and that has the names of the items and the prices. You've got other functions on here. For example, if I press coffee and I've pressed the wrong button, if I press the void item, that takes it straight off. If I press a few items, I can press void item a few times, and then it'll take off the items off the screen. I'll just show that example again. So I've done four items here. I can also go up and down with the arrow keys and then press void item and just get rid of the one I want. Okay. The next thing to do is to choose the payment method. Now if it's just cash, I would just press the cash 10 button, which is this button here, or cards and checks. So if it's a card payment, I press the button. And what happened then was the receipt came out for the kitchen, but what it didn't do was open the drawer, because if you select cards, you can then use the front of the drawer and then push the card slip into the front, like that. The same for checks as well. If we're choosing a check item, that won't open the drawer and I can push it in the front. There's a good feature here called print this. Now, if I was to have a customer that wanted a particular item, for example, they may want a grill salad, and if I press the print this button, I can then print anything I want onto the receipt, for example, no tomatoes, and then click OK. What that does is, if I press cancel now, that clears it off. Then that prints on the, comes up on the screen, but at the same point, it actually comes up on the receipt for the kitchen staff. You can see no tomatoes. So everybody knows what's happening. Right now, we're in the middle of service, and there's a few orders there. If I press the list of orders button, that then brings up the check number, how many guests there is, and who it is. And I can actually tap onto there, and then if I press the open button, that comes up with number 12 table number, 5 guests, 2 employees. And that's 2 sheet kebabs, Philly steak and medium, which is quite a good function. At this point, if the customer needed to pay the bill, I can press the print order button, hand that to the customer. They could then pay, it's £14.90, so I could pay £15, press cash send. I'll just go back to that, sorry. We go to tables, and it's table number 12, which is on the first floor. I can see there it's £14.90, and then I would type in £15, press cash send, comes up on the screen, and if I need a receipt, I can press receipt, and I can hand that to the customer. As you can see there, the one to hand to the customer before they pay is smaller than the one to give to the customer afterwards. So this should save you paper. That then stays up on the screen till we're doing the next transaction. So if I go back to tables there, I can see that table number 1 still hasn't paid. If we go to the first floor, we've also got table 11 hasn't paid. So to open that guest, press that one there. Comes up on the screen. I can print the order now. It's a smaller receipt. Hand that to the customer. They can come back. They're going to pay by card. So I'll go over to my card. Oops, sorry. Actually, that's printed off. I need to go back to tables. Back to that customer. The first floor. Open up the check. And then I can actually, when it's on here, can then pay by credit card or check. Right now I'm going to pay by card. That's it. Nice and easy, straightforward. So let's go back to the original table there. You can see that one's already open there. What do I want to do with this? I want to pay this. For example, they give me £15, press cash, and that customer's dealt with. If you need to print a receipt, press receipt, it comes out. If you wanted the receipt to come out automatically every single customer, there's a receipt on off button. You can see there, and it comes up on the screen. Receipt off, or receipt on. But if I use this method, the printer does print lots and lots of paper. For example, now, if I go to tables, open a tab up, okay, do a couple of items, and if I do store order, I get the receipt coming out automatically. If I go back to that table, finish on that, and then if I do type in, it's 12.45, they give you £15 cash. Get the receipt coming out as well. So it's pretty straightforward. Please call me if you want to go through any other functions. Thanks so much.